Hello, Saints. Thank you once again for tuning in. Today's message is titled The Way of the World. And the reason that I'm releasing this message is because of the way that people follow after things in the world because everyone else is doing it. And they follow after things in the world that they turn those things that they follow after into idols. It's just like today, everybody and their mama has a dog. And it seems like that everybody wants to have a dog. The pet stores are cashing in, the veterinarians are cashing in, and also the airlines are cashing in order to transport these useless pets from one place to another. And the reason why I call these pets useless, because they truly are that. They are more lazy than their masters, laying around the house all day long, urinating and secreting feces out of their rectums onto the floors of their masters over an 8-9 hour period while their masters are at work. Because I know, just like anyone else knows, that these animals have to use the restroom. And what they have done is turned their masters' homes into giant toilets, their toilets. And it's really not the case of the animal being a pet and living with the owner. The owner is living with the pet because the pet has turned the animal, the pet has turned the owner's house into a giant toilet. That's just like now as I'm standing here speaking to you, there are some dogs inside these units and they are barking. There are people that have 60-pound, 180-pound dogs living in a 1 or 2 bedroom unit and then they dare to not even walk the animal. They bring the animal and let it urinate and defecate right up under the window of where we live, right here, right in front, instead of taking the animal to a park and letting it use the bathroom. The grass is ruined. You can't even walk on the grass without almost being able to step in something. There's a sign that says pet waste transmits disease. Lease and clean up after your pet. It's the rule, $25 to $100 fine. People don't care about that, because there's poo all over the place. But people care about doing is following the way of the world. The scripture says from 1 John 2:15, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. 1 John 2:16, for all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. 1 John 5:19, and we know that we are of God and that the whole world lies in wickedness. Verse 20, and we know that the Son of God has come and has given us an understanding that we may know him that is true, and we are in him that is true, even in his Son Jesus Christ. This is the true God and eternal life. Little children, keep yourselves from idols. They have turned their animals into idols, and everyone is cashing in. My wife and I were watching a story online where it was talking about what it costs to transport a pet. And, you know, I thought maybe it was a couple hundred bucks. But if you have a dog that you want to transport, it can cost you $400 to $500 to transport that animal on a plane to one place to another. It's just like I said, everybody is cashing in on this thing, the way of the world. People have taken animals and they have made them almost more important than children or the family. You see people on game shows and when they talk about the person, they say, well, tell us a little bit about yourself. The person will say, well, I'm married to my wonderful husband or whatever. Or you'll have a man that'll get up there and say, I'm married to my wonderful husband, which is really a lie. But it's the way of the world. And they're cashing in on these same-sex marriage licenses. Just like they're cashing in on people having these useless pets. You have an animal that lays around your house for 8, 9, 10 hours a day, waiting for you to come home. You come home from work, take it out for 10, 15 minutes or 5 minutes, let it poo on the ground, and then don't even pick it up. My wife and I don't have a dog or any pets, because it's an added extra responsibility and it can be very expensive. But there are these people that claim that they love their animals and their dogs, and really they are fools and they should not even go near a pet. It's just like nowadays, you don't even hear about orphans or children that are orphans. You hear more about dogs that are being abused, and they tell you stories about dogs and honoring dogs and people, everybody has a therapy animal and all this. It is such ignorance, and it just shows that people are willing and ready to follow after anything that they see someone else doing in the world. The scripture said to keep yourselves from idols. And these animals and pets that people have, they have become idols. You know, you're going out, you're buying expensive dog food, you're getting expensive shots, you're getting expensive things, and some people even buy clothes to put on their animals. And you mean to tell me you're buying clothes to put on an animal and his body is covered with hair? He has hair all over his body for one reason, and that's because he is an animal. People let animals be in the bed with them like they're humans. People let animals sit on their laps when they're driving and lick all on their mouth when they're in their cars. I see it every day, and it's just too much, you know. But you see all these other people that they are doing what everyone else is doing just because they're doing it. It's just like right now, right? As I walk along the way here, you see all this animal poo on the ground. Look at that. Animal poo on the ground. Just gobs of it on the ground. See, all along here, animal poo right here. Animal poo right here. See that? And then we have a thing over there where you can pick it up and put it in a container. And people don't do it. And this is over by apartment buildings by where I reside near. And people are so lazy, and they have lazy pets that are useless just like them, that they have the audacity to be gone all day long letting their animal use their living room as a toilet while they urinate and secrete feces out of their rectums onto the floor. And then these people have the nerve to say that they love their animals and won't even take them out to use the restroom. And then it's filthiness and nastiness. Look at this. All over the place. Dog poo everywhere. You see that? Dog poo all over the place. And then we have these apartment buildings that are like right over here by near where I live. And this is where a lot of the people who have these useless animals live. And they're not only useless, but they're a nuisance because they bark and then they poo all over the place, and people have the nerve to not want to pick it up. Now, we live in a fairly decent neighborhood, right? And then you're walking along and here you see poo laying on the ground because somebody's too lazy to pick up behind their lazy, useless pet that has not become just useless, but it is also a nuisance because it's pooping all over the place. It's peeing all over the place. That's just like where I live. The lawns are ruined because people let their dogs pee all over the place instead of taking the dogs over here to like this open space that we have, because this is open space behind me and the dog could run wild over there. And the other direction that I just came from, there's another open space over there. They could take their dogs and let them run, and people never take their dogs and let them do anything. These people have 60 pound, 70 pound. I even saw somebody that had a dog that might have weighed 100 pounds living in their unit. And this dog stays in their unit all day long, waiting for their master to come home. It's a lazy, useless pet. And then people have the nerve to say, oh, it's cute. And then people have the nerve to go out and buy these animals, and they treat these animals like idols. And they bow down and they worship these animals. People do some of the most detestable things with animals. And this is the way of the world. Just because the world tells you you should have a dog doesn't mean that you should have one. Everybody should not have a dog. There are some people that should not ever go near a dog. That's just like right now. Another pile of poo. People refuse to pick up behind their animals. They say they love their animals, but they refuse to pick up behind them. It's filthiness. It's nastiness. And some people should never, ever go near an animal. How is this fair to the people that do not have animals? Look, poo all on the ground. And I know that these people who have these animals are guilty of this. And people who have animals are guilty of doing this. Walking their dog, letting it poo, and then have the audacity and the wherewithal to not pick it up. How nasty is that? How filthy is that? How ignorant is that of the owners that have these animals and they claim that they love their pets? Now, this is just a short way away from the apartment complex that I just passed. And this is where you see the larger amount of the poo. It's right by the apartment complex, just like over here. Poo all on the ground, all on the ground. Poo all over here on the ground, over by the apartment complexes. And that is because the people who have these lazy, good for nothing, and useless animals are lazy and good for nothing and useless, just like their pets that they idolize. People dress pets up in clothes. People take pets into their beds. People treat pets like they are children. That's just like one day I remember I was at a grocery store somewhere, and somebody had the nerve to bring their animal into the store. When I was a kid coming up, this was unheard of. But now we live in a time where ridiculousness is at an all-time high. And people think that they have a right to do whatever they want to do and to do anything that they want to do. And if someone speak about it, then they're immediately offended. And the reason that they are immediately offended because they know that somebody is right somewhere. How nasty is it that it tells you to pick up behind your pet because it tells you that it's filthy? And then you have people that they have nerve to do things like leave things like this on the ground behind their pets. And then people like myself and other folk that don't have dogs, that care about the neighborhood, that care about how things look, have to see this filthiness and this nastiness. And this is what happens. If it's not outside here on the ground, you can bet your bottom dollar that these dogs are urinating and secreting feces out of their rectums onto their owner's floors all day long. There is not an animal in society or in this world that can hold its bladder for 8, 9, 10 hours. My wife is even telling me that people have become so lazy that they've invented this thing that you put in your house like some type of a pad or something, and you let your animal poo on that. Your pet has turned your house into a giant toilet, and you have the nerve and the wherewithal and the audacity to say that you love your pet, but you're abusive in how you treat it. You do not take it out to use the bathroom. You do not give the pet something productive to do. It lays around doing nothing all day long except urinating and secreting feces out of its rectum onto your floor, ruining everything. And if it's a place that's being rented and people have cats and dogs and they keep them in their house, they'll urinate and defecate in the house that the stench will be unbearable. There are signs around that tells us, that tells people to pick up behind their animals, but they refuse to do it. There's poo all over the place over here on the ground. It's a shame how all of this is right here. And these people claim that they love their pets, and then they have the audacity to leave this filth and this nastiness on the ground because they say, oh, I love my pet. People are fools and they are idiots. That's just like, we just had some neighbors move in next door to us, and it's a young couple over there, and they have two dogs. The dogs got to weigh 60, 70 pounds each. I get up early in the morning. I wake up at like 5:30 in the morning so that I can get my reading in and spend some time with the Lord. And I always open the shades so I can see out, and it's usually nighttime. I never see anybody out there walking their dogs. And then sometimes I might see some people might bring their dog out once and let it use the bathroom, and then they'll take it back in very quickly, and then I'll see them leaving going to work. And they're gone all day long while their pets have turned their house into a giant toilet. One time I saw somebody that had a sign at a place I worked, and it says, I work very hard so that my cat can have a good life. That's funny, and people put it up there to be funny, but you know what? It's a serious situation. And this is actually what people are doing because they are following after, and they are doing what people are doing in the world. That's just like another example. Like, for instance, I've seen people where they have like their windshield wiper blades, that they'll take the windshield wiper blades and they'll put them up in the air. And they do that because they see somebody else has done that. How many years have they been making cars? With the technology of an automobile, they already know how windshield wipers work. Windshield wipers are made out of a specific type of rubber that when they lay on the glass of the automobile, you turn on the defroster. The defroster heats the glass in turn, and when the glass is heated, it transmits to the blade itself, heating the blade, and therefore the blade is unfrozen. You can pop the blades to get the ice off of it, but you are not told to put your blade blades up in the air so that when you come out, that they'll be all brittle and hard and it's easy for you to clean your windshield. People are doing that because they've seen someone else doing it. Everybody has a dog just because everybody else do. People are acting like these dogs are over children. That's just like now, like I mentioned before earlier in this message, you don't even see anything talking about children that are orphans or children that need parents or children that are being abused or children that we should love and take care of. But you see commercials from the ASPCA. You see commercials talking about dogs that need to be adopted. You see commercials about animals. People are using the pet because they're a therapy dog. Everybody named Mama got a therapy dog. They're bringing dogs in the movie theater. They're bringing dogs in the grocery store. They're bringing dogs in the restaurant. And then when you tell people that they can't do it, they get offended. And then there are many people who are molding what they're doing in order to be able to cater to these people that have these useless and pets that are a nuisance in order that they may be able to make money. When I was a kid coming up, they didn't have all these pet stores where you can go by and buy pets. I mean, look at the poo, just right here. Poo all on the ground, right here. See that? Right here. And it's right here by these apartment buildings where these people live. And they say that they love their pets, but then they bring their animals outside and let them defecate all over the ground and didn't have the audacity to not pick it up. And we know that this transmits disease and that it's filthy and nasty. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. And these people claim that they love their pets and it's filth and it's nastiness. I'm calling out everybody that has a pet. Look at all the poo over here. What a shame. This is not fair to the people whose houses are in back of this. This is not fair to the people that want to walk here. But because of the way of the world, it's telling everybody that they can have an animal. And people have these animals that they idolize, but then they don't want to clean up behind them. How filthy and nasty is that? And this is not fair to anybody that doesn't have an animal. And just like I had told my wife, and I say it many times, and I mean this, and I'm adamant about it. There are some people that should not go near an animal of any kind. The only way that they should see an animal is online, in a magazine, or anything. They shouldn't even be able to download the picture, because some people are irresponsible. They are lazy. They are unencourageable. They are filthy, and they are nasty. And then they have the nerve to say, oh, I love my pet. It's just like, I remember one time, I have a friend named Dave that I've known for a few years. And when I had first met my wife, I told my wife, I said, you know, we're going to go over to Dave's house and visit. And I said, but don't be alarmed, because his dogs done chewed up all his furniture. Because he had this one dog that was a Weimaraner, and this dog was huge for his house. And the dog chewed up a love seat. And when we got to my friend's house, my wife was in shock, because all she saw was a love seat that was just the wood, you know, the frame that the material hangs on. And all the material was chewed off of the frame and the cushioning was gone from the love seat. And my wife was looking and she surveyed the place. And then at one point we was visiting, and then as we were in a conversation, one of his dogs had the nerve to take a poo right there on the floor in the living room where we were standing. And I had to get out of there fast because of the smell and the odor. His dog was using his bathroom and turned his house into a giant toilet, and he was privy to that. And then, you know, after my wife realized this and she looked at all this and she thought about it, she turned to my friend Dave and she said, Dave, you know what, you seem like you know you're a great guy, and you know what, I like you, and my husband thinks that you're really cool. See, more poo right here. And my wife said to him, my husband thinks that you're a cool guy and he appreciates you, but Dave, it seems that you are living with your pets and your pets are not living with you. And that is the case for a lot of people. That's just like all these people that live in these apartments that has animals. Everybody have dogs now, or a cat or something. And these animals are not holding their urine in all day waiting for these people to come home so that their houses could be nice and clean. But what has happened is these animals that are useless, these animals that are a nuisance, have urinated and secreted feces out of their rectums onto the floors of these people that keep them trapped in their houses all day long. This is like, I have another neighbor that lives near where I stay. And this neighbor has a dog that's used to herding. you know, it's what, like one of those sheep dogs or something. And he keeps the dog locked up all day long. I never see the guy take the dog anywhere. And then he has the audacity to bring the dog out of the house for 5 minutes, if even that, and he takes it over to a little parcel of land to where the dog goes every time it goes to pee or poo, and that's where the dog goes to pee or poo, and then he takes the dog right back into the house. Now, some animals are not meant to be domesticated like that, and anybody that wants a lazy, good-for-nothing lap dog just because it's cute, you're an idiot. Because it's expensive to have a dog. You're going to pay $1,500 for a dog. Then you're going to pay another $500-$600 to have it inoculated or given shots or whatever. And then you're going to pay some more money for some dog food. And then you're going to pay some more money when your dog bites somebody and they sue you. People have these useless animals and they're calling them pets. And really, the human is the pet. Because as filthy as the places are that these people live in, I know these animals are urinating and defecating in the houses over 8, 9, 10 hour period. And to be true, it is not fair to the animal. And this is the reason why I say that some people should not ever go near a pet or be near a pet or have one. They shouldn't even be able to download a picture of a pet. As it's like this poo station right behind me. This poo station right behind me, you see a poo station right here, but people have the audacity to not pick up behind their animals and to leave it on the ground. It's nasty. It's filthy. It's deplorable. It ruins the neighborhood. It ruins the grass. But everybody is following the way of the world and think that they have a pet just because they could go and buy one. But really, the human is the pet. That's just like right now as I'm talking to you. There's people that have dogs inside their house and all they do is bark all day long and the pet is not responsible for anything. I remember one time my wife told me about a story about a guy that had these three dogs, and the dude would go to the store, and when he would come home, the dogs would run out of the front door of the house because they knew the master was there, and then they would sit in line, and the guy would line up grocery bags, and the dogs would pick up the bags and then carry the bags in the house and not pilfer through the bags or look at any of the grocery, any of that. They would take the groceries inside the house, put it down, come back, get another bag. Animals love to be put to work, and we have dominion over them. We are not to be the slaves of animals, but people have become the slaves of animals. They have allowed their pets to turn their houses into a giant toilet while they are at work. Tell me, do you know of an animal that holds its bladder or its feces inside its rectum for 8 to 9 to 10 hours while its master is away? No animal does that. And this is the reason why I am determined that many people who have animals and do what they do, they doing it just because they seen somebody else doing it. They're following after because they seen somebody else following after it. They're doing that because somebody else is doing it. And just like I've said, all the poo that I showed you laying around on the ground that people leave on the ground because they say they love their pets so much, but then they have the audacity to not pick up behind their filthy, nasty, useless nuisance of a pet. And those who don't have dogs, you may step in it or anything. It's a shame, because the way of the world is not always right, and some people are not right in their minds, and they should not be taken anywhere near a dog. I mean, that's just like, you know, you see poo all over the place, and you got signs that's outside your front of your house, and it say pet waste, transmit disease, leash and clean up after your pet. It's the rule, $25 to $100 fine. And you know, there's many people that they don't care about that fine or anything. They don't care about anything but what they get and their own satisfaction. They don't care the filth that it breeds. They don't care what happens. And then all the other people that are selling these products to animal owners and to animals or whatever they're doing, everybody's cashing in on it, because everybody that lives in the world now or live in the United States thinks they have the right to own an animal, when some people should never ever go near a pet. They shouldn't see a pet. They shouldn't even be able to pet a pet. They shouldn't even be able to talk about a pet, because the only thing that it does is it brings harm to the pet, and it just shows how ignorant one is when they're following after the way of the world instead of doing what is right. I do pray that the Lord will add a blessing with this message.